Welcome students. In last lecture we learned some properties of root locus, that it is symmetrical about x axis, that means real axis. We also learned what is the angle and magnitude criteria. Now we will learn rule number 4, that is angle of asymptote. So it is a root locus branches which terminates to infinity. Number of asymptote is equal to poles minus zeros. The angle of asymptote gives us the direction along which this P minus Z branches approaches infinity. Angle of asymptote is given by phi A is equal to 2Q plus 1 into 180 degree divided by P minus Z, where Q equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 up to P minus Z minus 1. So if we have 4 poles and 1, 0, up to what value of Q we will calculate this angle? So P is 4, 4 minus 1, 3, 3 minus 1, 2. So Q equal to 0, 1, 2. There will be 3 values for Q and hence 3 values for this angle of asymptote phi A. Rule phi O is centroid. It is intersection point of asymptote on real axis. So asymptote intersect at the point of centroid. It is denoted by sigma. Centroid is given by this equation. Summation of real part of poles of open loop transfer function minus summation of real part of zeros of open loop transfer function divided by poles minus zeros. With this example, it will be more clear. So see, calculate the asymptote and centroid of following transfer function shown in the figure. So this is the transfer function. What is our sigma? That is real part of poles of open loop transfer function minus real parts of zero of open loop transfer function divided by P minus Z. So how many poles are there? Pole is equal to S equal to 0, S equal to minus 1, minus 2, minus 4. So there are 4 poles. So what is their summation? 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 4. Okay, minus real part of 0. 0 is only at minus 3, so minus 3. And hence, it becomes minus 4 by 3. Poles minus 0 is 4 minus 1. So this is the centroid, means at 4 minus 4.3. These asymptotes will intersect on the real axis. How you will find angle of asymptote phi A? By equation 2q plus 1 into 180 degree divided by P minus Z, and here our Q is 0, 1, 2 by that formula. So when you will put Q equal to 0 in this equation, so 2 into 0, 0 plus 1, that means 1 into 180 upon 4 minus 1, and that is 60 degree. When you will put Q equal to 1, it is 2 into 1 plus 1. So 2 plus 1, 3. 3 into 180 upon 3. And that becomes 180 degree. And when you will put Q equal to 2, it is 2 into 2 plus 1. So 4 plus 1, 5 into 180 upon 4 minus 1. So these are the angles. 60 degree, 180 degree and 300 degree. And these are shown like this. See, this is the S plane. This is real axis sigma. This is imaginary axis j omega. Okay, and centroid is located here. See, minus 4 by 3. So minus 1.3, this is minus 1, this is minus 2, so 1.3. And what are the angle of asymptotes? First is 60 degree. So this asymptote will start from centroid. So this angle, it is 60 degree. Another is 180 degree. And third asymptote, it is at 300 degree. So this angle is 300 degree. So this is marked on the S plane. We will see what is breakaway point and how to find it. Breakaway point is a point on root locus where two poles meet. Once the two poles meet, they split. That means they break away from real axis. And how to find this breakaway point? First, write the characteristic equation. That means 1 plus g of s, h of s is equal to 0. Now arrange this characteristic equation in such a way that k equal to f of s, that is a function. Then differentiate this k with respect to s and equate it to 0. This will give valid and invalid breakaway point. Then we will decide what is valid breakaway point. That means whether that breakaway point lies on the real axis loci by that rule. That to the right side of that pole or 0, summation of poles and zero should be odd. See, by example, this idea will be more clear. Determine breakaway point for the following transfer function. So k into g of s h of s is equal to k into s minus 3, s minus 5 divided by s plus 1, s plus 2. And when you will solve this, we will get this value. On root locus, we know magnitude condition, k g of s h of s is equal to minus 1 plus j 0. Okay. And by solving this, we will get this equation. Now we have to differentiate this with respect to s. So what it will be? Dabba k by dabba s is equal to 11 s square minus 26 s plus 61 divided by s square minus 8 s plus 15 bracket square. That is equal to 0. And hence, our s values are 2, minus 1.4 and 3.82. So out of this, which is our real value? Which will lie on the real axis loci. So see, this is breakaway point. S is equal to minus 1.45. Because number of poles to the right side is odd. That is only 1. And that's why root locus right. This is a real axis loci. So this is shown in the S plane. Now rule number 7 is intersection with imaginary axis. This rule gives us point on the imaginary axis which the root locus will cut while moving to the right half of the S plane. So this root locus will move from left half to right half and it will cross at the imaginary axis, and we have to find that intersection with imaginary axis. So intersection of imaginary axis can be found by using Ruth-Hurwitz criteria. Procedure to calculate intersection with imaginary axis is like this. First, write characteristic equation 1 plus g of s h of s is equal to 0. Then construct the Ruth array. Determine k, get the auxiliary equation, and then compute the roots of auxiliary equation. These will be the intersecting point with the imaginary axis. With this example, idea is clear. Determine the intersecting point with imaginary axis with the following transfer function shown in. So this is the transfer function. Okay. How many poles are there? S equal to 0, S equal to minus 1, S equal to minus 2, S equal to minus 4. And 0 is only 1, S equal to minus 3. Now first we will find characteristic equation. 1 plus g of s h of s is equal to 0. So we get this equation. Then from this equation, find the Ruth array. So maximum power is 4, hence s raised to 4, s cube, s square, s raised to 1, s raised to 0. And then write this coefficient. You know how to write the Ruth array. So this coefficient 1, 7, 14, 8 plus k and 3. These are written like this. 1, 7, 14, 8 plus k and 3. Then you also know how to find this value. So 90 minus k is equal to 7 into 14 minus 8 plus k divided by 7. That becomes 90 minus k. Then this also 20k. You know how to find. And we have to calculate value of k from this row, s raised to 0 and s raised to 1. So 21k equal to 0 and positive k, only s raised to 1 row can be all zeros. So this positive value, this s raised to 1, s raised to 1, this. So minus k square minus 65k plus 720. This k square minus 65k plus 20 upon 90 minus k equal to 0. So this numerator will become 0 and we can find the value of k from this equation, which is 9.65. So the system is stable for 0 less than equal to k less than equal to 9.65. Now at 90 minus k a square plus 21k equal to 0. Okay. So place the value of k 9.65 here. You will get this equation. And what is the value of s? It becomes minus plus j 1.59. So the root axis, the root locus crosses the j omega axis at this value at a gain of 9.65. And all these quantities are recorded on this s plane. Sigma is real axis, j omega is imaginary axis. These are poles, s equal to 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 4. We indicate poles by cross and zeros by 0. So there is only 1, 0, minus 3. This is centroid. These are asymptotes. This is angle 60 degree. This is second asymptote, 180 degree. And this is third asymptote, 300 degree. And see, these are the intersection point. So this root locus will shift from left side of S plane to the right side of half plane, and this it will intersect the imaginary axis at this point. So this point is minus 1.59. This. And what is the gain at that time? K equal to 9.65. Then we will see how to find angle of departure and arrival. So angle of departure or arrival, this rule gives us the angle along which the complex pole depart or arrive from their original position. And this angle of departure is given by phi of t is equal to 180 minus phi, and angle of arrival is given by phi a equal to 180 plus phi. See, with example, determine the angle of departure from the following transfer function given in the figure. This is our transfer function. So one thing is important, poles must be complex. At that time only we can find the angle of departure or arrival. So solution is like this, k into g of s h of s is equal to this transfer function. So by solving this, these are the roots of this bracket, s plus 1 minus j, s plus 1 plus j. And by solving this, what angle you will get? Angle k g of s h of s is equal to minus 1 plus j1. Okay, and that is equal to minus 71.56 degree. Clear? So this is the angle of departure, minus 71.56. This is only phi. And the angle of departure will be 180 minus phi. And that becomes 251.56 degree, and it is shown here. See, these are the complex conjugate poles. And from this pole, this is the angle of departure. Okay, this is theta 1, this is theta 2, this is theta 3, and this is theta 4. A feedback control system has open loop transfer function g of s h of s is equal to k upon this. Plot the root locus for k equal to 0 to infinity. And we will solve this example step by step, which will cover all our rules. Okay, so this is one ideal example. What is first step? Find number of poles. How many number of poles are there? 4. So poles are at s equal to 0, minus 4. And what are the roots of this? Minus 2 plus minus j. There is no any 0. So number of zeros are 0. So what is the angle of asymptote? Phi a, we know this is the formula. Now we'll find value of q. Q up to p minus z minus 1. So 4 minus 0, 4 minus 1, 3. So you will put q up to 3, 0, 1, 2, 3. So there are 4 values. And hence first put q equal to 0, you will get 180 upon p minus z, and that is 45 degree. Then put this q equal to 1, and you will get all these 4 angles of asymptote, which are 45 degree, 135 degree, 225 degree, and 315 degree. Then we will find what is the centroid. So centroid means it is the point on the real axis where asymptote intersect. We will measure this angle from this centroid. We will measure angle of 45, angle of 135 at this point sigma. So what is formula for sigma? Summation of real part of poles of open loop transfer function minus summation of real parts of zeros of open loop transfer function divided by poles minus zeros. And when you will put all these values, it becomes minus 2. So what is the meaning of that minus 2? On the real axis at the point minus 2, these asymptotes will intersect. Then we will find what is breakaway point. We know it is given by characteristic equation equal to minus 1. So this is equal to minus 1. So what is value of k? This will be the value of k. Now we'll differentiate this with respect to s. So dabba k by dabba s will be this one. And from this solution, we will get s is equal to minus 2 and minus 2 plus minus j 2.45. So there are 3 roots. So which is valid one? Valid break point is that which lies on the real axis loci. That means summation of poles and zeros to the right side of these poles should be odd. And of these 3 roots, only s is equal to minus 2 is definitely a valid breakaway point as it lies on the root locus. Then we will find what is the angle of departure. So angle of departure is given by this equation. We will find this at value s is equal to minus 2 j4. How this value is minus 2 plus j4? This is the value, minus 2. And therefore, these are the asymptotes, breakaway point, and angle of departure will be like this. And so angle of g of s h of s at s is equal to minus 1 plus j1 equal to minus 90 degrees. So we will find this at every s. Okay. And hence phi d is equal to 180 minus phi, where phi is minus 90. So 180 minus minus 90 equal to 180 plus 90, and it is 270 degrees. Then we will find intersection with imaginary axis. So what is characteristic equation? This is the characteristic equation. Find a Ruth array. So highest power is s is to 4. So s is to 4 cube 2, 1, 0. Write this coefficient 1, 8, 36, 80 and k 0. How to find this 26? 80 minus 8 into 36 divided by 26. Divided by 8. That becomes 26. And this is the k. So 0 minus 8 into k divided by k. So what is the maximum value of k for stable system? It is obtained by equating column SS to 0 and SS to 1 to 0. So k will be greater than 0, and this SS to 1, this term will be greater than 0. And hence, for stability, what is value of k? K should be less than 260. Then and then only system will be stable. When k equal to 260, it will be marginally stable. And when k becomes greater than 260, system will go to instability. The marginally stable, for marginally stable, we should have a rows of zeros. And what is k marginal? It is 260 degrees. And this plot, it is completely shown here. So you may draw this plot on our simple graph paper. It is not semi-log paper as in case of Bode plot. How to plot all the points? So first, draw S plane with sigma and j omega axis. Then locate the poles and zeros. Then mark centroid, which is here. Centroid is, what is your centroid? Yes, our centroid is here. And so we will find this angle of asymptote. So first asymptote, see, this is centroid. Okay, it is minus 2 and 2.45 j. So this is first asymptote from this point, from centroid. So this angle is 45 degree. Second angle is 135. So from this centroid, make 135 angle. Third is 225. So from this centroid, make 225 angle. And for fourth angle of asymptote, 315, you will measure here. Then we can plot what is the breakaway point. And hence, this is the complete construction of the root locus. So in this way, when you will go step by step, it is very easy to draw the root locus and find the stability of the system. And you can also locate what is the k marginal. That means for which value of k, system will be marginally stable, unstable, and we can decide it from k marginal. Thank you.